In this video, I'm hoping to show that electricity has characteristics that are similar to water. So I'm drawing a brick wall here, and I'm going to get myself a hose pipe. And I'm going to squirt some water through the hose pipe at the wall. So my water's flowing out of the hose pipe, squirting it towards the wall. Once it hits the wall, which is a resistance, it trickles down and we get a puddle at the bottom here. So we can see the pressure of the water flowing out of the hose pipe, or visualize the pressure. So we're going to say there's 12 kilopascals of pressure forcing that water out, and it's flowing towards the wall, which resists its flow, trickles down, forms a puddle, and the pressure in the puddle is zero. So we've got pressure up to the resistance, and then zero pressure after the resistance. We can see that there's an amount of water flowing out of the hose pipe. So if we look at it here, we can say, let's say there's 4 litres per minute flowing out. And there will be 4 litres per minute flowing into the puddle. So there's no difference before or after the resistance in terms of the amount flowing, but the pressure is different. So let's compare that to a simple circuit. So I'm going to have a lamp in my circuit. Here's the battery, and I'm going to connect the lamp like this. So it's a really simple, straightforward circuit. We're going to say that our battery is a 12 volt cell, and that's going to push the electrons through the circuit. We use conventional current flow. So on this side of the circuit, there will be 12 volts of pressure, 12 volts worth of force pushing the electrons up to the resistance. On the other side of the resistance, on the return side, there would be 0 volts. And so if we connect a voltmeter across the consumer, across the resistance, so we connect it in parallel. Let's draw that on. There's my voltmeter. There we go. What we're actually measuring is the pressure on one side, or the voltage on one side. So we have 12 volts on this side. So we write that down, and we're going to compare that to the pressure on the return side of the circuit, where there is 0 volts. So what shows on the voltmeter is the difference between the two. In this case, 12 minus 0 is 12. So we see there is a volt drop of 12 volts. It's dropped from 12 down to 0. Okay. Thanks for looking.